On Saturday, August 17, 2024, our most treasured Supreme Master Qinghai, vegan, took time from her intensive meditation retreat for the benefit of the planet to speak about how recently hearing a poem that she had written decades ago had deeply touched her and reminded Master of the beautiful, dreamlike life that she wants us all to have in this world.
Hello, all my dear friends. May God bless you, love you, and show you His love. May you also know His love and blessing. Today, while I was preparing a little meal for myself, I coincidentally listened to one of the earlier poems. It must have been written some decades ago. And I was so kind of surprised, mesmerized, listening to it. It was in Alasis. And when I read the translation, I thought, oh, there's some words missing, not translated correctly. I mean, detailed. I think I have to revise, check out the translation and add in some more words to make it more complete and perfect. Never mind, it's not the main point. The main point was that I was so homesick listening to that. I can't remember the whole poem now, you know, so quickly in my head. Many poems I wrote spontaneously, naturally, and I did not always have time to check and to correct or to make some additions. And I have to thank you, the team, the one that thought of that poem and put it on our schedule to air.
Không thể sống được đâu, cuộc đời giam hãm quá. Tôi muốn đi thật xa về vực miền hoang lạ, vượt lên khỏi đống cung đến địa đàng thơm hương, nơi gió trôi dịu dàng, mến mong lòng bình an, đời như là mộng đẹp, giá vào ta thanh thang. Nếu người không bình lặng, đừng gợi hãy chiều em, để tôi cùng cánh chim, cùng mặt trời vươn dậy. Tôi sẽ nằm mơ trên cung trăng và làm thơ bên cạnh hoa lan dài, cá vui trong làn mưa mát rượi vào hè, trèo cây rừng và đùa sóng trùng dương ngày xuân sớm mơ, tổ tranh trên cỏ mời. Tôi sẽ tung tăng cùng bướm vàng ẩn với cá sông, hát những câu đồng dao tàn đêm thu mát, dạo con đường mòn tân yêu mời mọc, nhặt trái hồng vừa rụng xuống ân cần. Sống cuộc đời đơn kết những hân hoan, quên sau lưng bao thị phi oan trai. Tôi chỉ muốn được là tôi, được thở hít khí trời. Thiên thần xin hãy giúp Thượng Đế, xin cứu người.
This and many more poems by Supreme Master Qinghai, vegan, are free for download at suprememastertv.com. poems.smchbooks.com.
Oh, it was really refreshing my mind so much, refreshing my heart, and made me a little nostalgic. Because the poem was beautiful, not because I made it, but because it is beautiful. It probably speaks to many of the viewers, especially those God disciples who are under my care. Sometimes I forget, or I don't know how to express it. They say my disciples, but they're all God's disciples. I'm just a humble instrument to communicate what God has already bestowed upon them inside their hearts. Now, I was taken away by the poem, even though I wrote it myself, but it's been so many decades already. Time passed so quickly. Only now I realize that my time is so precious because there are so many things I can do and have done and can do still and will do with my time. It's just that I feel like my time is so short. The poem was really so awakening to me, even though I wrote it and I know some of it, still remember some of it now that I have listened to it. Before that, I also knew about it, but I didn't have time to think about my past, only the present and the future of the world. It takes too much, all of my attention, all of my time, all of my energy. I have to always keep renewing myself, renewing my energy in order to keep up with the work that is assigned to me by God Almighty and all the Buddhas, saints, and sages in all directions and all times. The poem has some expressions that really still strike me, you know, and it awakens my heart. And see, it makes my emotion, my dream, come alive again. Yes. Something like, I would like to be me, myself only, and do the things I really like to. Even if other people think they are crazy and foolish, I will like it. And I will have my dream on the surface of the moon. I will rise with the sun in the morning. I will write my poetry on the leaves of the wild orchids and paint on the blades of grass. Imagine how free, how carefree can that be, that you write your poem and do not think or care whether or not it will be printed or it will remain on the orchid's leaf. Imagine how weak the orchid's leaf can be, very little, very small, very fragile. But you would write a poem on it, and so I offer it to the universe, to God Almighty, to all who can connect with you or not. Or doesn't matter if they enjoy or not. You just wrote it because you wanted to. And paint on a blade of grass, imagine how long can that last. But this was my dream. I mean, a poetic kind of expression. The dream of a carefree life, of a life without any plan, any organized thoughts or any concrete arrangement for the future or for anyone to see or for anything at all. You just do it because you want to do it. This is something good. It's awakening me again, and it brought me to tears. Because that's the life I want to have for this world. And I'm still working on it. I'm still fighting for it. You have seen many predictions about our present years on Earth. Like about 2022, 2023 even, especially now stronger, still stronger, 2024 up to 2027. We have too much upheaval, too much disaster, too much sorrow, disease, and all kinds of new disasters and diseases come up. Our old ones revisit. Those deadly, terrifying kinds of pandemic diseases that we thought we had put behind us or overcome.
Disease X could be on its way. British healthcare professionals are gearing up for disease X, which they say may be deadlier than COVID-19 and may have a similar impact as the Spanish flu. The WHO says disease X could be a new agent, a virus or a bacterium or fungus without any known treatments. An expert, Kate Bingham, who has issued a warning, mentioned that the virus has the potential to result in 20 times more fatalities than COVID-19.
The upper estimate is 100 million deaths in 1918. This time it may be 400 million people died. That is a really horrendous number.
Would you believe me if I told you that the assassination attempt on President Trump's life was actually prophesied in great detail months ago? Back in March, this guy named Brandon Biggs actually prophesied in some detail the events that just transpired.
And I saw Trump rising up, and then I saw an attempt on his life. This bullet flew by his ear, and it came so close to his head that it busted his eardrum.
I have a hard word to give today, and I ask you to be patient with me here.
I hope the Holy Spirit can get through this.
The Lord took me, and I saw a complete shutdown of society beyond anything you can comprehend, even worse than 2020. He said, this, what is about to happen, has not happened for hundreds and hundreds of years. It would be a type and shadow of the Black Death in the 1300s. There was no anti thing for your arm. Nothing. There was nothing to stop it. Anybody who contracted this thing was gone. Then I saw 350 million again, worldwide. Then I saw 30 over the United States.
I guess I'm emotional now. I can't express myself very well. Please forgive me. That dream, I want to have it for myself and for you. I will make it. I want to make it come true. Please, fight with me. Fight with me. You don't have to have weapons. You don't have to go kill anybody to win. Win yourself. Have a victory over yourself. Just put down anything to do with killing. Renounce killing so that you won't get killed in the same way. That's it. Very simple. Repent to God. Vow to yourself that you will U-turn so that one day we will go back to heaven. Together, or one after another, I'll be waiting for you to welcome you at my heavenly abode that God has permitted me to create for you. My home is not here on earth, but my home is in heaven, where it never can be destroyed. You will never be eliminated, harassed, molested, or oppressed in any kind, in any way at all. You will live as you, yourself, as in the dream that I have written about in that poem when I was of younger age. I don't feel old. I tell you honestly, I don't feel old. It's just my body sometimes complains. because I overuse it. I work day and night sometimes. I don't care about eating, sleeping, unless I truly can't wear no more and drop to death somewhere on the floor or on the sofa. It doesn't matter. I work because I know if you're happy, I'll be happy. If you're in pain, I'll be in pain. I work for myself, but in your name, in the name of God, but truly it's for myself because it's unbearable, all the pain I witness every day, even just from the news, from the screen of the television or my little phone. It is still real to me, and the pain is raw and will never stop until this world becomes a paradise. I mean, less than the real paradise, perhaps, but why not? I ask God why, if they want to stay here, why not? If they want to stay in their dream, in the dream state, you know, in the illusion, why not? Let them be. But at least it has to be nice and comfortable, just like a heavenly world. I want to make this world a heaven for you. Those who don't want to go to the real heaven still can enjoy a heavenly life, peaceful life, wonderful life, just like the way I dream in my poem. When I was so desperate, I remember the poem is called Screaming Out Loud. And it was in desperation for this world, seeing this world in such a sorrowful state, that I wrote that poem. And I want to make that dream come true. Thus, I've been fighting all these decades with you and without you. I just hope one day, very, very soon, you will help me. Fight with me on my side, by my side, so that you will have that dream come true, a heaven on earth where you could still have everything, but wholesome things, healthy things, saintly things, because you be saintly beings who live on this planet as if in heaven. I have sacrificed everything. All my physical magic, for example, like you could fly in the air, traveling by air, not airplane, but yourself in the air, and escape from danger by being invisible. Disintegrate your body in times of trouble and reassemble it again somewhere else so that you can escape temporarily. You know, you can walk through walls, through doors, open any locked door of the prison or anything at all when you want to be free. These can make a more convenient life for me, a more comfortable life, but I had to sacrifice all that because I interfere with the world and you're not allowed to use any magical power openly. But sometimes I had to use it to some little thing to cure my dog person, but still I had to pay dearly. And it's, even if you want to pay for everything, you can't do it. You're not allowed to. Otherwise, you will be stripped of your title, thrown away from the mission, and God probably will never want to use you again or let you be in existence again. Not to talk about being a master. In the initiation time, we have told you how to know which level you are in the five levels, what kind of landscape, scenery that you will see inside your vision. And further upward, the near realm, not the outside things. No, no, nobody can see what you see. And what kind of melody, music, or teaching from God you will hear at what time or stage of your spiritual development. You know all that. So do not try to claim yourself as whatever guruji or great master or even Buddha already. How can you be? You know, you know that you don't have anything at all. You don't know anything about the inner world. And you're such a low level. I know some of you might want to help others. So exactly for that, we must do the right thing. If someone is hungry and thirsty, you can't just give them dirt. You must give them proper food and liquid to drink, and medicine if you can. If you cannot give what's needed and might even harm by your ignorance, then it is a disaster for both. Because if you're a little higher level, even lower level, you would never claim yourself to be anything, because you're still nowhere. Even if you see the master come visit you in your home, you know, the manifestation, the light body of the master comes, you're still nowhere yet. You're not even halfway through. Not to talk about if you go above the fifth level, or even at the fifth level, in order to master the power of saving others, and you still have to suffer, even then, because no matter how much power you acquire from your initiating master, you still don't have enough. Not for this world, no, no. That's why many masters initiate very small numbers of disciples. Many of them don't want to. Because if you want to practice well for yourself, you do not try to interfere with others' karma, as then both sink like a small boat that can't be overloaded. Because God gives the master all the power, but the master can share only, you know, some with each individual disciple. When I heard that some initiates claim that they are Maitreya Buddha, I said to God, "Oh, please, can you give it to any of them?" I was, you know, at that point, a little exhausted from karma, from all sides. God laughed and told me, "No, he will die immediately. He can't give you all the power. Number one, you will be dead. You can't bear it. Number two, the master has to share with many disciples and save some for himself." And I told you at the moment, nobody, not one of my disciples or other people's disciples has reached that stage of complete enlightenment so that he can fulfill all the power from God, and God will give him power to go out and initiate other people independently. No. So please don't make a clown of yourself. Oh God, it's too cheap theater. It's a very degraded copy. And you yourself know it very well, because you know nothing. You're too low, otherwise you wouldn't claim like that. Because you would know that to falsify God's gift is a heinous sin, resulting in relentless hell punishment. You're just talking with your ego, and the demons are cheating you, puffing you up so that you will be their instrument. And when you finish in this world, or when they don't want you, they will drag you down. Look at other so-called masters in front of you. Like, for example, the living Buddha boy and Ruma, whatever. Yeah, it's ruin, not Ruma. So cheap, so ridiculous. Even I myself can't bear it. This is so sickening. This Trang Tam or Ruma deliberately misinterpreted my old poem to claim successorship. And that guy, I don't want to reveal his name yet, added some new words, altered the sutra to claim Maitreya status. Then call himself a great master. He stole my teaching and gave half-baked initiation to trust in vulnerable people who don't have real blessing and visions as they should do from initiation. How dare they do such and claim such in the eyes of all the Buddhas in all the transparent universes? There must be demons themselves to be the anti-heavens, hell dwellers. When I reread the Kuan Yin Sutra or Avatamsaka Sutra, there was no such thing in there.
The Nepal police has arrested Ram Bahadur, the self-claimed spiritual leader, who's also known as Buddha Boy. Now, the God-man is facing allegations of abductions and rape of his followers. The authorities said that they arrested the 33-year-old man from a house in the outskirts of the capital city of Kathmandu. And they also confiscated banknotes amounting to over $227,000. Now, officials also found foreign currencies amounting to $23,000.
Kính bạch sư phụ và kính gửi đội ngũ truyền hình Vô Thượng Sư. Đệ tử được sư phụ truyền tâm ấn đến nay đã tròn 32 năm. Hôm nay, đệ tử xin làm nhân chứng cho những lời sư phụ nói về ác quỷ Trần Tâm. Câu chuyện này con đã giữ kín mấy chục năm nay vì chính hắn đã nói, thanh danh của người sứ giả nằm trong tay nhà ngươi. Vào năm 1996, lúc hắn về Âu Lạc Việt Nam giả làm sứ giả Quán Âm, con có tham gia vào nhóm làm việc giáo lý. Lúc đó con mới tròn 20 tuổi. Vào lúc nửa đêm hắn gọi con vào phòng riêng và xâm hại tình dục đồng giới với con. Lúc đó con thật khủng hoảng tinh thần vì con nghĩ một sứ giả của sư phụ phải là một thánh nhân cao quý, sao lại làm chuyện trần tục ghê gớm như vậy. Nhưng vì lòng tin tuyệt đối nơi sư phụ nên con xem như không có gì xảy ra và tiếp tục làm công việc giáo lý cho sư phụ. Và sau đó rất nhiều lần hắn lại làm điều đó với con và dặn dò con không được nói ra. Về việc hắn nói là sư phụ truyền kế vị cho hắn, đó là hắn lấy câu trong bài di chúc của sư phụ, trong đó có tên của hắn, rời cõi trần tâm.
Chú thích từ sư phụ, đó chỉ là một bài thơ, trong bao nhiêu bài thơ của sư phụ, không ăn nhầm gì đến hắn, trần tâm ở đây hay bất cứ ở đâu, không viết hoa, viết chữ nhỏ thường, không phải là tên, chỉ có nghĩa là cõi thế gian, cõi hồng trần, thế giới này. Là tên thì phải viết hoa chữ chờ, chữ tờ. Sư phụ chưa bao giờ gửi Trần Tâm về Âu Lạc Việt Nam để làm sứ giả Quán Âm. Người có vợ con không bao giờ được địa vị này, chỉ người xuất gia mới có thể là vậy. Hắn là tên giả mạo. Hắn mạo xưng như thế là chuyện làm phi pháp. Hắn không bao giờ hỏi sư phụ về việc này. Không ai nói gì cả về tên này với những vụ hỗn độn liên quan đến việc này.
My Will, poem written by Supreme Master Ching Hai Vigen in 1979 in Germany, originally in English, translated by the editors from the poetry collection The Lost Memories, printed by Jia Huang Printing Company in Taiwan or Formosa. M said this poem was written when she was still in the world, engaged in Germany, long before she left home to search for enlightenment. No one knew this poem before she became known as Supreme Master Ching Hai, not related at all with her work before and after that. List of all to a fake, for profit like Chan Tam. He used it to manipulate innocent, vulnerable people by his evil intention.
Nếu ngày mai trần gian tôi từ giã, gia sản này xin để lại cho anh. Ngoài anh ra là quyển thuộc ấn tinh, trên cõi thế chẳng còn ai run run, lòng cũng thấy mềm say. Nắn nót tên ai, từng nét vơi đầy. Người thừa kế gia tài tôi hiện hữu, dấu tay in hẳn con tim bận bịu, tình ngậm ngùi theo dấu mực loáng qua. Gia sản đây anh hãy nhận làm quà, dăm mảnh áo một tủ tiền trống rỗng, sách với thơ chưa bao giờ ấn tống, không kim cương không vàng bạc lụa là, có con chẳng những lời thơ vô giá. Người yêu ơi, xin gìn giữ vẹn hữu tròn. Bởi vì anh mà nguồn thơ rộn rã trong canh thâu, hay những giấc mộng tan, nên biết lòng tôi sẽ vui vô hạn, rơi cõi trần tâm chẳng bận luyến thương. Vì từ khi anh biển biệt xa phương, đời đã lãng chim dần trong cõi chết. Tôi vẫn biết là cuồng điên vô ích, là dại khờ, là vớ vẩn ngu si. Nhưng lòng tôi một cõi lòng tha thiết đã theo người trên mỗi vết chân đi. Xin gìn giữ chút gia tài bé nhỏ, dù thân này còn lê lất hay không, dẫu phù sinh con ngược xuôi lần nữa, thì đời tôi sống thác có ai mang.
This and many more poems by Supreme Master Ching Hai, Vegan, are free for download at suprememastertv.com/poems and smchbooks.com.
Rồi Tết năm đó, hắn tổ chức khoảng hơn 20 xe gắn máy toàn thanh niên nam nữ cùng với hắn khởi hành từ Long Khánh về miền Tây chơi. Khi đến Long An thì có hai bạn nữ đã đâm vào xe tải đi ngược chiều và tử vong tại chỗ. Thế nhưng hắn vẫn dửng dưng lạnh lùng đi chơi tiếp tục. Nay con xin tuyên thệ đây đều là sự thật. Sư phụ dạy không nên nói xấu người khác, nhưng nay sư phụ nói người thế gian phải biết, nên con xin làm nhân chứng để cho người thế gian rõ hơn về tên ác quỷ này. Đệ tử xin cầu nguyện sư phụ sẽ ở lại mãi mãi với địa cầu xinh đẹp này. Kính chúc đội ngũ truyền hình Vô Thượng Sư sức khỏe dồi dào và tràn đầy ân điển của Thượng Đế. Đệ tử từ Âu Lạc, Việt Nam.
When you are initiated into the Quan Yin method by an enlightened master, you have only a certain amount of power to uplift yourself, to protect yourself and some of your generations. And if you're good, of course, 9 generations will be all liberated. But that is only for you and your loved ones, your friends, and even your pets, perhaps. It depends on how large the family and clan. But it's not enough for you to go out and proclaim yourself as a master and kind of initiate other people and liberate them. No, you must have God's permission and God's appointment. Then God will give you enough power to liberate others. You can't have too much power in this world. As a newling, just as a baby, can't take adult's food. And the physical body cannot absorb all that in one go. So everybody knows that you are fake. Don't degrade yourself. The whole universe is no. God knows. And you know. You know that you are no one, nobody. So just try to calm down, meditate for yourself, your families and your clans. That is a lot of work already. Being a master, you have to have enough power from eons of time of practice and connection with God, and have to be permitted by God and other universal hierarchy. You can't just play with God's power, with universal judgment. You can't just cheat. You can't just lie to the whole universes, okay? At the time of initiation, we talk about that already. You should keep quiet. You should not reveal what you learn to others, because the verbal instruction alone is nothing. It's the master power that lifts you up, cleanses you, and helps you to improve spiritually further. But you're not allowed to just go out and give initiation by yourself like that. Only when the master sends you, tells you. Every time, each time, not just tell you one time and then you can continue to do it your whole lifetime. It's not like that. Because you don't have enough power to help people, lift people up to higher heavens, and to protect them from all dangers on the road. You don't know where to lead them to, because you yourself don't know the way. Only the master knows it. And when master assigns you to initiate in the name of the completely enlightened master, and you let the master know their names, then they will be officially initiated and the master will take responsibility. But without the master's permission, you can't do anything. And in no time, empty of master's grace and protection, you and your followers will be all fallen into the ensnaring clutches of Mara, the devils in hell. Myself, I shudder thinking of that horror. So for any of God's disciples, under my guidance, if you have done all the wrong things that I have mentioned before, you should stop it. Don't just jump in to learn a couple of instructions and then jump out and give people initiation. Then shamelessly boast about yourself as a master or even a great master. You must ask God for forgiveness. For being disrespectful to God Almighty and trying to delude His precious innocent children. Because your karma is too heavy. You have to keep repenting for the rest of your life, hoping God will forgive you.
Master gives protective warning to all interested in Kuan Yin spiritual practice. Because of much abuse of our generosity and leniency by ignorant people and demons hidden in human form, from this day on, the 21st of August, 2024, anyone who fakes Kuan Yin messengers or tries to teach the Kuan Yin method without official permission from Master and confirmation from Central FG must be avoided to protect yourself from being harmed in any way. This caution must be applied by all contact persons, all meditation centers, all initiates, all future initiates, and all should report to M as soon as possible if such a malign event ever happens again.
So don't try, yeah? Don't try to claim something that you're not. The whole universe sees you. All the Buddhas know you. All the saints and sages identify you. And God Almighty knows whom has sent to be his representative and who is not. And in this time of world elimination, only one Buddha can help this world. One savior can help to save this world, to minimize disaster, or will kind of banish them. From 2024, because the other years are past already. Still, the other years have a lot of warnings for us, a lot of disasters, pandemics, all kind of things to warn humankind, and also to eliminate the bad elements who live on this planet in the form of humans, but sometimes not, because they don't behave like how a human is supposed to do or supposed to be. Humans are the children of God. And if any of them don't behave like a child of God, then they will be eliminated. But God still sends many masters down to help you. Not like God lets you come down here and abandons you. It's not like that. It's we, the humans, who abandon God. Thus, being far away from the protective power, from the blessing force, and being punished to no end in this life and the next, in hell. I don't want all this to happen. I've been shedding tears all these decades because of all this. But I never stop working for you. You still have me to rely on, to lean on, if you walk my way. Because I can't help you if you walk in the other direction. I don't have the power to stop you, because you yourself are also a child of God. You yourself have the right to decide what you want to do. It's your life. We all respect that. But if you choose to destroy your peace, happiness, and wisdom, then we cannot do anything. We did a lot, the heaven workers and I. I'm one of the heaven workers under the grace of God. Many predictions about our planet from different kind, gentle, and wise people all over the world have predicted this period of our life is going to be crucial. We can make it or break it. And I do hope that you can make it with me. You can lean on me, but you have to walk with me. I used to be shy. I didn't say too much. But I feel more empowered now, so I can tell you who I am. Of course, reluctantly at first, but I have no time now to play hide and seek with you. You must come out. Walk with me. I must come out to show you where I'm walking, even though I also show you halfway where to walk. But you still did not catch it. Many of you, oh, big numbers of you have not caught up. Please believe me. I told you already. You don't have to follow me. You don't have to do anything. Just be repentant. Ask God for forgiveness. Return to your original self, which is benevolent, generous, kind, okay? To all beings, from humans to the plants, wherever you can, avoid harming them. Avoid at all costs to harm them. Then you'll be fine. That's all you have to do to save yourself. I want you to live on this planet. If you want to continue that way, and why not? It's just that you cannot destroy your home while you're living in it. The way you live your life, harming living beings like animal people, big trees, and all kinds of things you do, taking drugs, alcohol, and cigarettes, living very unwholesome lives, you lower your own power that has been given to you by God. Each human has an amount of power, not to just survive, but to create, to make wonders. Many do that. Some scientists are sent from the higher heaven to help you also, but they don't do harm to others. So we should not, if we don't want to be harmed, then we should not harm anybody, anything, any animal, people, any living beings, even little insects. The people, the humans who want to follow the Buddhas, who want to be saints, or at least liberated, enlightenedly liberated from this cycle of birth and death, they have to avoid harming others in any way at all, if they want to go to heaven. But that is not a high demand. Like if you practice the Kuan Yin meditation way with me, it's not a high demand to just ask you to be vegan and meditate 1/10 of your time every day. That's a tithing. It's not about money that God's talking about. The tithing is not about money. It's about your time, so that you can continue to sustain yourself in such a troublesome world, so you can balance your life and you don't fall, so that you can go back to your real home in heaven after you finish your duty or mission in this life, or even just to have a pleasure to check out this world. You have to keep the rules in order to live well here and go home after. Nowadays, we have too many things and we forget God. That is the problem. We can enjoy, but don't forget God, huh? Don't forget God who provides all this for us and has taken care of us since the day of our birth already. We forget God, so we run into all kinds of opposite directions. Anything that's against God that we follow, because it seems short-sightedly fun or different, but it's not as fun as if you know God and know the world inside while living in the world outside. You can live in two worlds, heaven and earth, and enjoy both if you know how. And it's not that difficult. For example, if you take up the Kuan Yin method, you meditate 2.5 hours a day. It doesn't have to be all in one go, maybe morning some, nap time some, evening some, and at night some before sleep. And you just denounce all the killing products, you know, or the murdered products like animal people's meat or fish people's flesh, anything to do with living beings. God has allowed and tolerated us to eat all kinds of vegetables and fruits, even though some of the fruits and vegetables do feel pain. But it's a minimum punishment, almost nothing. If we eat a vegan diet, no harm to other kicking, living, breathing beings, then you're all right. At the end of your life, you will go enjoy heavens. And maybe you don't ever want to come back to this world again. Even if this world will be made into Eden, if you know the real heaven inside is a real world, you will never want to set foot here again. That's why I ask you to thank all the masters, meaning Buddhas, Imams, Gurus, Mullahs, etc. You know, in different countries, they call the masters different names, different titles. Like before, when Lord Jesus was born, his name was Jesus, but his title was Christ. The Buddha, before he was born, the title Buddha was for him after, for those like him who had attained complete enlightenment and can help others. Not everyone who attains complete enlightenment can help others because of the affinity, like the Buddha, who has been Buddha for, whenever, you can't never even count it on the greatest computer machine. But he has to come back again and again into the human's world or even some kind of heavenly world as the Dharma will-turning king of heaven and come down as a normal human in order to show affinity with other humans who are still mired in ignorance, so as to keep connected with them, with their soul. And then when his time comes, he can become Buddha, saints, or lower status than a Buddha to help them through this affinity, you see. So it's not like you say you're Buddha and you think you're Buddha, then you are Buddha. Oh, God. There's nothing more incredulous than that. Nothing more silly, nothing more stupid than that. So please stop it. Yeah? Whoever you are, whether you are initiated by me or any other masters, stop this nonsense. Whoever becomes master, it is by God's appointment, by God's will, and will be announced by God, and all heavens, all the universe will know it. And you will know it. They haven't reached anywhere yet. In the astral level, they just see a flickering light sometimes. Talk to some of the invisible beings in the astral world, and they thought, that's it. And that they are Buddha already, completely enlightened, and even claim to be Maitreya Buddha. Ah, yeah, this is something that I just remember now. Some days ago, someone who was formerly my disciple and detached himself out, claimed himself to be Maitreya Buddha and kind of wanted to fight with me or something. Not fiercely, but kind of, you know, angrily, yes. I read something like that. And I say, no, he's very low, that's why. Oh my God, la. Even if he's practicing anything, you know, then his ego grows too fast to control because of admiration, perhaps, from some maybe vulnerable people. Until he got the Kuan Yin method, and then he got something much, much better, and then he thinks he's Maitreya Buddha. What for? If you are a Buddha, what can you do for the world? What can you do for the suffering beings, which you haven't done anything for all your life anyway? Even if you have illusion and the whole world says you are a Buddha, you yourself know so well that you are not, that you are nothing. Don't be so shameless.